said that you have around 12 process that you have developed so far,
Yeah.
close to. So what are the process that you rejected to your business, stating that, okay, this is the project that you came across in a wrong method and you should not do automation for this particular process? Is there any such process?
Yeah, currently we have given some scan PDF. Actually, those were not PDFs, those were some image files. So they used to provide somewhere handwritten files. So it was not able to read by human as well. So we rejected, we tried doing some, but it was not working. So we rejected those processes that it, handwritten, so it's not correct. So we can't read. So we tried, then robot was also not giving expected results, means hardly 10 to 20% it was giving. So we told them that it cannot be automated if this is the handwritten or image files.
So since you are having 5+ years of experience, let's not go too deep into the development or the activities. Let's go something related to the business as well.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're saying, okay, when you are working with an RPA project, not every RPA project will be a successful practice.
Yes.
Okay. Now, what is the lifespan, or what is the lifespan a bot can be deployed properly? Let's say that we have deployed a bot. Mm-hmm. Now, for how many days can it be like that? Maybe minor changes might be required. And what is your expectancy, or how many years can it stay like that? For how many years?
It actually depends on the process. So suppose if you are automating some Oracle or Java application, for Oracle application, they automatically auto update the patch after every 2-3 months. So UI gets changed. So you need to do some changes in selectors and all those things.
Okay.
So it depends on process and application.
Okay. So within the process that you have developed so far, how many processes are such that till now, once you have deployed, you never need to make any changes? Is there any such process?
No, I have not faced such scenario till now.
So you're saying that on every monthly basis or weekly basis, we need to make sure that the process need to be changed.
Yes.
So what is the time that you go back to your or what is your response time for such issues? Let's say that you have deployed a bot.
Yeah.
And the bot is there in the production, and what is your methodology, or how do you make sure that the bot is running? And when the bot fails, how are you making sure that respective business is informed about it, and as well as the support is informed about it?
Yeah, so if bot fails, and suppose if we run through again, and if we find any UI changes, we are informing the business per team that these are the UI changes, so we need to change in the code. So once we inform, then again we need to provide the estimation approx what time it will take. So based on that, we will do the changes and we will again deploy it in production.
Okay, what can be the response time? Like if I receive a error today, when that can be resolved? Maybe a week after or 2 weeks after? What is the response time?
It depends actually on if complexity of the process, because
let's say whatever process you have developed, say with that respect,
2 days
at the max. You need to reply back in 2 days.
Yeah,
so let's say
we used to do root cause analysis and we used to provide them in a day or two. So based on that, again we need to provide estimation and we need to ask them for changes.
Okay, so during a root cause analysis in an RPA failure, what will you exactly check?
We first run through the orchestrator, then we monitor the log messages in orchestrator tab, so where it's exactly for failing, and then once if we can find out from that log messages, we can go through the production machine and we can run without disturbing any other processes. So we can debug on that there, and we can exactly find out on which activity it's failing, or whether UI is changed or not.
Okay, what is the logging mechanism that you are using right now?
Login mechanism means?
In the sense, are you storing all the logs, or are you storing only the fatal ones or error in the orchestrator?
Information and error.
Information and error.
Yeah.
Other than that, you are not storing any other logs.
No.
Okay, so when you are unable to find with these logs,
mm-hmm.
let's say that there is an error, maybe we'll get the error log as okay, in information we'll get all the details. And what if we are unable to find out with these logs? How do you get the data?
Yeah, so then again we need to, where its process is running, we need to debug it through UiPath Studio, and from there we can find out where exactly it's failing.